Hello, everyone. I simply cannot believe that it's been a week. Here we are, a week later, bringing you the rabbi's words of wisdom, which just goes to prove how quickly life and the days and the hours are going. So if this doesn't teach all of us to appreciate every minute of the day, enjoy life, do the best you can, just do anything that makes you and your family and your neighbors and your community happy, you have my permission to do it all. And here's the rabbi.
Shalom, hello everybody. It's nice to be able to speak again on the parasha of the week. This time, the parasha is Vayera, Hashem el Avram, talking about God appearing to Abraham. And when Vayera Hashem el Avram, Belone Mamre, in the turbines of Mamre. And it's very interesting that the picture that in our imaginary eyes that we have, the Torah portrays that for us, Avraham Avinu, in a most wonderful light of what he represent, what his character is part of his makeup, and a character that is worthy to emulate. The Torah pictures Abraham as a person who cares about people. He is, after all, immediately after he had a Berit Milah, the circumcision, and he feels in a way uncomfortable. It's only a few days after the circumcision, and he was 99 when he did that. Ooh. And it's not an easy task. And he circumcised himself and his entire male household. Ooh. And the Torah tells us a little bit about the weather forecast. It tells us kehom hayom, meaning the burning of the day, meaning the heat of the day. And our rabbis tell us yotzichama min arteka, like God took out the sun out of its closet and he brought it bright. Why? Because God cared about Abraham. He didn't want anybody to bother him after the Berit Milah, after such an incredible operation in those days. So, but he was concerned about the fact that he see there are no wafers. He lives in that part of the, in like a desert. It's very, very hot. And he is thinking about other people, how they must be faring, how the people who are thirsty or hungry, that they need some comfort, they need something to release their suffering. And so, because of that, God sent him three angels. And like, if it was three simple wayfarer Arabs that were in the desert, and the way it portrayed the Torah, how he welcomes them, and he not only, he just say, come and wash yourself and refresh yourself, and I'm going to make sure you drink, you eat. And he didn't say very much, but at the end, he really served them of the best steaks, filet mignon, and also milk, the best that he had.
Milk and
so
meat.
This is, yes, yeah, that's a good question, right. But nevertheless, this is how it was, how the Torah portrays Abraham. And in fact, many Medrashim says that Abraham, in his youth, he perfected this characteristic, this ability to welcome other people, to care for people, because he wanted constantly to emulate God, what God is all about. After all, his most important thing was to do exactly represent God in this world. What does God do? I mean, God doesn't need anybody, doesn't get anything from anybody. God created this world and everybody that is in it to be kind and to give of himself to everybody else not to take anything. Abraham was the same thing. He cared about every creature, about every person, no matter who they are, what color they are, that he didn't count. For Abraham, if a person is there who was created in the image of God, he was there to help. That's the character is incredible. So after this is after the Brit Milah. The most interesting thing is that the Torah said, Be'elone Mamre. Where this happened that God was communicating with Abraham? It was in the terebinth of Mamre. You know, he had a field, Mamre, he was the owner, and he was a Baale Berit Abraham. He was a good friends of Abraham. He had three friends, the Midrash Tela, Aner, Eshkol, and Mamre. And in fact, the Talmud says that he needed advice from each one of them. He asked advice. Should I do the circumcision or no? Should I, what God is ordering me for the first time to circumcise myself and all my family, should I do it? So, you know, Aner decided to say, you know something, you are quite old and it's very painful. I don't advise that you should do that. Eshkol said, I don't think the pain is the problem. You going to be able to stand the problem. But why should you mark yourself with something externally like that, like a Brit Milah, to be different in front of your enemies? You're going to have people who are going to be anti-Semite there. There's no point in just go and mark yourself. What for? You need that. And Mamre said, you know, you should trust God, because after all, didn't he help you when you came out from the fiery furnace? Didn't he help you as well when he told you, Lech lecha me'artzecha mimulavtecha mimulavtecha avicha el haaretz asher areka, go from your household, leave everywhere to a land where you don't even know. I'm going to show you later. And you trust him. So why should you trust him like that? And this is the Midrash. And therefore, because of that, God said, because you helped Abraham and you reassured him, therefore it's going to be name that I communicated with Abraham in your field, in your terebin. And that's why the Elone Mamre. The question is a little bit difficult. It's amazing that Abraham needed to get advice. After all, Abraham went to many tests. He never asked any of his friends, should I do it or no? What was so special about the Brit Milah? It's not just that he didn't want to because he could endanger himself or not. Abraham knows that if there is a commandment from God, he will do it. So what is it so special? What was so special about the Brit Milah that he needed to have counsel from his friend? And I think that the answer for this is a little bit unusual, but most probably, can you imagine that, you know, Abraham, what was his main purpose? He existed for one thing. That's why he was wayfarer. So he wanted to present God to the world, monotheism. What he did was what we call kiruv, you know, to go and bring people closer to God in the best way that he could. That was his mission in his life. He perfected this in the best way. So, ve'et ha'nefesh asher asu be'Haran. Also, I mean, all the soul that they made Haran, our rabbi tell us, mean all those that he converted to monotheism. If that's the case, Abraham thought for a moment, you know why? I am one of the people. You know why I can relate to everybody? Perhaps because I am like everybody. And like what we say, you hire a youth director. Why? Because you look youth like everybody else, the same. That's the draw. But if I were to now change and something external that I would have, perhaps nobody is going to think of me because I'm different. So therefore, they are not going to take any notice. That went through his mind. But, you know, I think at this time, Avraham Avinu realized there is much greater influence at it. Why? Because his representation Everybody who saw Abraham saw what you could be, how great you could be. Everybody who saw Abraham, they were impressed beyond normal. And so therefore, it was a moment when he needed to stop being just an influence and start to be a light to the world. That's what was Abraham, really. Abraham, that's why he is in doubt. What should he do at this moment? But the friends, assured him, Mamre assured him and encouraged him to say, nothing to do. We are born, the people, Jewish people, starting from Abraham, like a child, a male child is born, we do a Brit Milah. We are born to be different in the senses, to be special. And in spite of that special, we go along and we do what we needed to do. And that was the situation with Abraham, why he needed counsel for a moment. But he realized that at this moment, it was the best thing that he could do, because not only influencing people, but he being that light that needed to be for everybody. Shabbat Shalom.